I think in the case of Hong Kong, it's the West, I guess, made two main mistakes. First off, just the setup of the handover was really ridiculous. The idea that the British government expected the Chinese government to respect one country, two systems for 50 years was kind of a fantasy. And I don't think that anyone who really looked at the character of the Chinese Communist Party could have really believed that that would have worked. So I think that that deal should have either never have happened, which would have been what obviously I would have preferred, but at least there must have been some sort of mechanism in place to actually ensure that freedom and human rights would be respected in Hong Kong, and they weren't, and that led to the situation we have now. Second off, I think that the moves to allow immigrants from Hong Kong have been great, but other than that, I feel like politicians will often like tweet out thoughts and prayers and aren't really taking much tangible action to actually stand up to the CCP. When other regimes across the world do horrible things and break treaties, we see sanctions, we see serious repercussions, but we don't see that on the part of China. And there's a number of reasons for that. And I understand that there are economic interests tied in with all of this, but in the end, we have to stand up for human rights, and we can't let China just steamroll people in Hong Kong, do what they're doing in Xinjiang, which is absolutely terrible, and do what they will do soon in Taiwan. And to answer your question, how do we stop what's happening in Taiwan? Well, the first problem is we haven't stood up to them in the past, and so they're not going to be afraid to go roll over Taiwan. And I think that what we need to do is start just standing up to them now in general. We can't let China get off the hook so easily for COVID, regardless of the origin of COVID. And it looks more and more like it's possible that the virus came from the lab. But regardless of that, China was clearly not transparent, and they exacerbated the situation. And we cannot let them just get a free pass for that. They need to face some sort of international repercussions. And so we need to start now and show them that destroying lives of people around the world is not acceptable. And we'll send a message to them that if they go to Taiwan and they destroy the freedom of the people there, then the world will not accept them as legitimate state, a legitimate government that we want to interact with and do business with. So also with Taiwan, I think it's important that we in the West give them more legitimacy as a state. We need to officially acknowledge that Taiwan is in sovereign control of the island of Taiwan, which in the US, you know, we don't actually acknowledge that. While we've gotten a lot better about dealing with Taiwan, and now we are more transparent, and we actually go out and we talk to Taiwanese officials and things like that, we still haven't officially recognized them. And that's a big step. And the reason not to do that is we're worried about angering China. And in the end, we can't let bullies drive our policy.